From Jammu and Kashmir, Home Minister Chidambaram has announced a slew of measures by the centre to help calm tensions in the valley. After a meeting of the Cabinet Committee on Security this afternoon, he said a group of interlocutors led by an eminent person will be set up to begin the process of dialogue with all political groups in the state. Among other steps, one the government hopes will build confidence quickly now, is the decision to release every stone pelter in detention and drop the charges immediately.
The Government of India will appoint a group of interlocutors under the chairmanship of an eminent person to begin the process of a sustained dialogue with all sections of the people of Jammu and Kashmir, including political parties and political groups, youth and student organizations, civil society organizations, and other stakeholders. We will advise the state government to immediately release all students and youth detained or arrested for stone pelting or similar violations of law and to withdraw the charges against such students and youth. Three, we will advise the state government to immediately review the cases of all PSA detainees and withdraw the detention orders in appropriate cases. Four, we will request the state government to immediately convene a meeting of the Unified Command and review the deployment of security forces in the Kashmir Valley, especially Srinagar, with particular reference to descaling the number of bunkers, checkpoints, etc. in Srinagar and other towns, and to review the notification of areas as disturbed areas. Five, Government of India will grant ex gratia relief to the families of the deceased persons at rupees 5 lakhs per person killed in the civil disturbances since June 11, 2010. Six, Government of India will appoint 2 special task forces, one each for Jammu region and Ladakh region, to examine the developmental needs of the 2 regions with particular reference to deficiencies in infrastructure and make suitable recommendations. Seven, we will request the state government to take steps to immediately reopen all schools, colleges, universities, and other educational institutions, hold special classes or lectures if necessary, and ensure that the examinations for the current academic year, that is 2010-11, are conducted. Eight, Government of India will provide to the state government a sum of rupees 100 crore as additional central assistance in order to make grants to schools and colleges for improvements and additions to the existing infrastructure such as classrooms, auditorium, laboratory, library, playground, toilet complex, etc.
Well, Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Omar Abdullah, who had met the Home Minister earlier, has welcomed the centre's announcement.